What began as a FEMA trailer alternative after Hurricane Katrina, spurred on by the housing crisis of 2008, the tiny house movement, a national push for simple living centered on the development of, yes, tiny houses, has continued to gain popularity. So what does that have to do with Brattleboro? That story begins with Chad Farnham of Farnham Cellulose Insulators, who envisioned building a tiny house as a way to help a group of 4th to 6th graders at Hilltop Montessori School get hands-on experience as part of their Practical Life Work program.
I framed up the tiny house with the 4th, 5th, and 6th grade students, and they did all the measuring, they did all the calculations, we taught them how to figure out angles and how to cut rafters, and we framed the whole project right there at school.
And with the backing of local hardware suppliers like Leader Home Centers, Janowitz & Son, and Sherman Williams donating the materials, the team was able to construct a finished 6x12-foot house.
It was fun to see how they came into the project thinking they would sort of be watching or just doing some simple measuring. And then when we started giving them the hammers and the nails and, you know, spent time with them to safely, you know, use power tools, how they sort of grew and became really comfortable with that. And it was really nice for us to see and be part of.
A new house that fetched over $17,000 for the school and for Morningside Shelter after it was raffled off at the Strolling of the Heifers parade weekend this year, leaving an overjoyed raffle winner with a new house and an overjoyed community with a new partnership for learning, fundraising, and practical living.
It's a good experience, I think, for not just the kids, but for all of us involved to see that what we did helps more than just the school itself.